There was a time when I was really young where I really looked up to my father. In fact, I thought that I might be a preacher one day. You know, all little boys want to be what their father is, and I'd sit down with him in his office and I'd be scratching out on paper my sermon that I'd be preaching on Sunday. And I thought at one point I was saved and sanctified, but nothing seemed to work and it just wasn't making sense. I guess the hardest thing I had to face was probably the first thing in life. I was 6 years old, and I had a little girlfriend. We were in kindergarten together, and then in first grade, she burned alive. Don't let your mind get weary and confused. And she died, and I went to her her funeral and saw, you know, the body was all made up, but I can still remember that there was a makeup line on her arm, and I could see charred skin underneath of it. And that was the first time I had to face death and then wondering where she was, you know, for all these years and what would happen to her. I just can't accept the fact that a loving God would take a six-year-old girl and burn her alive.
Incredible. I could be working right now. Yeah. Technically, I am working.
There wasn't just one day where I felt there is no God. This is something that was very long in coming and out of a lot of search for myself and a lot of thinking and obviously a lot of reading on my part and trying to analyze exactly what there could be. What is there out there? Why is it that so many people believe in religion but I don't? So it was a process over very many years, obviously decades and so far my lifetime. When I came to California, I met people from all over the world. In fact, I got some jobs that required me to do a lot of travel. And I traveled around the United States, I traveled overseas, somewhat to Europe and Japan. And I met people from different religions, walks of life, the way that they live, the way that the people not necessarily live religiously, but just enjoy life itself and what they do to succeed. And then I saw the opportunities that were laid out in front of me. And I didn't have to pray for these things to come true. I just had to pick up a few books, start learning, get to work, put my nose to the grindstone, and I could make things happen. Life in itself has always existed, I think, in the universe one way or another. Whether it was simple aminos, whether it was bacteria, the various elements that made up our universe, I mean, those things have always been. We're just an amalgamation of those things. We exist for those. And then everything that then takes on life fights to keep it. If there was ever an afterlife, I feel I'm a very good person. I've done a lot of good things in my life. I think that if there was some type of eminent being that we can't comprehend, that there would be no way that he would send me to some type of eternal damnation for not paying my dues at a church and attending a church and following their rules and regulations for what they do. But I have also just a very good gut feeling that when I die, the lights will just go off, and that's it, and I just cease to exist.
It's a whole butter clam. Obviously, the seagulls got to it first. I used to love collecting these type of things, but then you get them home for a while, and you get up the next morning, and your apartment or house starts smelling like seafood. And then it starts smelling like dead, bad seafood a couple days later. Unless you boil it, I guess, you know, and get all that out there. But All that just amazed me, though. A little creature can actually grow and a skeleton's on the outside of its body just all calcified like that. Maybe someone else walking along the beach will find this and I'll leave it for some little beachcomber.
I think that we should live for just the sake of living. Time is basically an asset that we all have. And the magic of what we are and what's taken so long for us to evolve into what we are, to then be and have our own existence for a brief period of time, be it 30 years, 50 years, 70 years, 100 years, maybe maximum, you know, that if we don't take every single one of those moments to enjoy things such as art and music and love and all those great things, that we're robbing ourselves. Wouldn't it be a shame that since we became what we are as humans, and so many things in the universe didn't, that we just threw that all away?